Hello friends, I am Uday Sagar Kanpal and I am back here with yet another lecture on Java using NetBeans IDE. So the topic for today is how to calculate the square root of a number without using the inbuilt function of mat.squareRoot or mat.sqrt. So before that, I would like to ask all my new viewers to please subscribe to my channel and please like my video on YouTube and please comment and share and also press the bell icon for notifications. So without wasting any time, let's start. So public static double sq square root. So let's define a variable here to which we'll be using for calculating the square root. So we define a double low equals to 0.0, a double high which will be equal to d, and a double mid which should be equal to d, or we can say 0. Now we will start with iterations for int i equals to 0, I smaller than 1000, I plus plus. So we will define mid equal to low plus high by 2. So we'll use the bracket here. So we will start with the condition if mid is equal, mid into mid is equals to the number d, we will return mid as we have found the square root. Else if mid into mid greater than d, then high equal to mid, else low equal to mid. So this way we have now got the square root. Now we just need to return the mid. So we return the mid in here and our square root function is complete. So let's try out. So before that, let's find the number double d equal to 99, and we can also calculate the time for this function. So double execution start equals to system dot nano time. We are using the nano time to calculate the nanoseconds that have been elapsed since this function started. Now we will calculate the square root, of d which we have calculated over here. And now after that we will again calculate the time. This time we are calculating the difference to find out how many seconds have elapsed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.0. So let's run the code and we can mark the seconds to denote the time. So we have calculated the square root of 99 as 9.9487437106.62. We can write here square root for method 1. We can place the plus sign over here. So square root method 1 is 9.94987, which is correct answer. So now we will calculate square root by one more method, which is also sometimes referred to as the Babylonian method. So I have created the method signature over here, public static double sqrt double d. Now what we will do is double start equals to 1, double end equal to 1 or D, and while the while condition would be while n minus start is greater than a particular difference, that would be the decimal point till where we want the accuracy. So the accuracy could be this. So now you would write the innermost conditions inside the while loop. So the condition should be end equal to start plus end by 2 and start equal to d by end. This is the Babylonian method. Now we will return. So we will return this. So we just removed any extra decimal precision which is not required. So we first converted into long by dividing it by the accuracy, and then we multiply it by same to calculate the to truncate the remaining digits. So now we have calculated this SQRT. Let's again copy paste these functions over here and let's use the method SQRT and let's initialize the execution start again. Let's run the code by marking it as method 2. So we have calculated the same result in two different times. So the result is accurate and correct. This is how we use to calculate the square root. So to calculate the square root, this is the first method using binary search method. This is the second method using the Babylonian method. So hope you like my video. Thanks for watching it. Bye-bye.